Yo, 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 check it out, man. We at this. Yo, 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 it's your boy Vonkeith, Barber, you know. I'm at the bar. You left the message. You know, cut that. Let's start it over. All right. Yo, 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 it's your boy Vonkeith, the Barber.
So today, we're doing a ball drop fade, and I'm going to go ahead and keep that blend really low and really curved. And as you can see, I'm just curving towards the back of the head, and I'm contouring the head just to make the fade pop. The technique, the wrist work, all coming into action. Now I'm just taking my clippers and I'm just doing my trimmers, and I'm just balding the rest of those small hairs just to give it a real clean look. Now I'm going up just a half an inch with my fourth notch on my Andes Masters. And I'm just doing the left side of the head today, just so y'all can see, you know, a real precise view of how I'm really fading. Now sometimes, you know, I have difficulty getting out that blend line between the ball line and the fourth notch. So what I like to do is I just take the lever and I, you know, put it between that fourth and that fifth notch and really just, you know, finesse that blend out. Now taking my zero guard, it's all the way open. I'm just creating another guideline. See, these guidelines are really important, man, because they make your fades pop and they make you know, keep you organized, and it makes your blend come out a whole lot easier and a whole lot better. Now I went ahead and took my zero guard up just a half a step. Just to go ahead and start knocking out that bottom line. Take your time on these blends. Don't rush your blends. Don't try to skip any steps, or you're going to have a lot of cleaning work to do and your fade isn't going to come out right. See how that blend just coming out real smooth already? Now I just close the zero guard all the way. Taking that fade just a little bit higher, probably about an inch or a half an inch. I went ahead and closed my number one guard all the way. I'm just working out the bottom line. Notice how I'm continuously combing my fade through, just to keep the hair down, just so you can remind yourself where that fade is. Now I have my two guard all the way open. and you see how I'm just C-cupping the hair. I don't want to dig too far into it because I want to keep that fade pretty dark on top. Still sticking up. Now I'm just working through the blend lines, working through that fade, making sure, you know, all my work is cleaned up. My favorite part of the haircut, that hairline. This thing is about to be extra crispy. You see how much hair I'm pulling down just from me pulling the hair out. And that's what I try to tell barbers, you know, or people that I mentor. You know, you want to pull that tape line out sometimes. Now I'm using my Wall Heroes with a custom modified gold blade made by the hair tailor. Please go check him out. The man has some really good products. As you can see on my tape lines, you know, I'm just tapping it. You don't want to go too much into it, especially with some sharp trimmers. I'm not saying my trimmers bite or anything, but you don't want to, I mean, it just keeps you from creating scabs and stuff on your client's head. As you see, I'm making that C-cut. It brings that fade out even more, man. You know, people try to, some people will try to say we don't push the line back on the side, but it's really not pushing the line back. All I'm doing is really just bringing that fade out. You see the technique, just the comb, just combing out that hair. Because when I put my enhancements in, I don't have any troubles or I don't have any cleanup work that I have to do. Now I'm just spraying the hair a little bit and I'm going to use some NUDRED Curl Cream. I'm just going to sauce some curls up and make them pop. How the NUDRED just does this magic, man. That is some really good stuff. Keep that blend going from the fade into the hair. I'm using this clip over comb. Also just making the hair real nice and even. See, people try to finesse, but even with curly hair, you know, you can still you can still tell if the hair is uneven. There it goes. My infamous white pencil. This thing does magic, man. And now before I apply my hair fibers, I was just, you know, applying a little bit of hold spray. The hair fibers I'm using is called Enhanced Hair Fibers, made by Shuka the Barbers. Real hot right now. You can go find them at therichbarber.com. His website. just touching that hairline up again with my Andes. These clippers were also made by the hair tailor. You see how just really smearing it out. And don't be afraid to follow through on your tape line, man. Sometimes the tape line's gonna take about 15 minutes to really get right. So take your time, man. Yes, sir. Left side's been tackled. Now it's time to tackle that right side. Voila. Straight pressure applied. Just like my boy Get Bean. Please like, comment, and subscribe. I'm dropping dope content every single week. Thank you for watching my video. Please come back soon. Peace.